Hi, welcome back to Cooking Healthy in Indian Country. I am your host, Megan Baldy, and today I'm going to be focusing on our winter squash. So I'm going to take you over to my harvest basket over here, and I'm going to pull out our winter squash for today, and it's the butternut squash and some delicata squash. Both these squashes came from Hoopa. They were grown right down the road from me at Spencer Hills Farm in Nortonfield. I'm going to be using those today. Now, I have already pre-prepped my squash. I peeled it and I also de-seeded it. This is the butternut. One thing about butternut squash is it's really hard to cut into, so I cut it in half and I took the skin off and I scooped the seeds out. The same with the delicata. I cut it in half and I scooped the seeds out and it's all prepped. Now, one thing that squash carries is fibers, and the fibers that are in squash are very heart healthy. So there's other things that squash has, and we'll talk more about that later on. But I'm gonna start with cutting up my squash. I have my oven prepped to 400 degrees, and so I'm gonna start cutting up my squash. I'm gonna bring you down to my cutting board down here, and then I am going to show you what I do. What I do is I like to take the squash and cut it lengthwise. Now be very careful, the squash is really hard to cut through. So just be careful with your hand and finger placements. It's kind of slippery and you don't want to slip up and slice into your hand or to your fingers. So I'm going to just cube it up. One thing you want to try to do is get a uniform cube to your squash because you want it to cook evenly. I'm going to place that on my parchment paper and my cooking sheet. I'm going to do the same with my delicata. I'm going to cut it down lengthwise. So I cut it down lengthwise, as you can see, and I am going to toss it a little with some olive oil. But I want to also talk about some things about the squash. Now, this squash is low in fat. It delivers an ample dose of dietary fibers, making it an exceptionally heart-healthy, friendly choice. It carries vitamin B6, essential for proper functioning of both the nervous and immune system. So one thing I like about winter squash is it comes out during the winter. It is an immune booster, which also promotes your healthy body and a healthy immune system during this cold and flu season. So I'm going to add that to my sheet over here. And I am going to bring my sheet over for you to see. If you can see today, I'm going to kind of bring you up just a little bit and angle you differently, is I am wearing my Hoopa Warriors, Go Warriors, apron. This is from the Hoopa Boosters. If you're interested in buying one, they are $20 each, and you can get them from Heidi Jarnigan or Kelly Jarnigan. So I just wanted to give a shout out to my team, number 57, number 69, whoop whoop. So I just wanted to show that to you. We're going to go over here. I have this olive oil. Spencer Hill gave me this olive oil for my cooking show. It is made locally in Eureka. Spencer has it for sale. It's $11 for 375 milligrams. This is extra virgin olive oil. I like the extra virgin olive oil because it has a thick consistency to it and it holds the heat, and it's also not as absorbent as like a cheaper olive oil. So I'm going to drizzle that over top of my squash here, my parchment paper, just like a few tablespoons. I have some sesame oil. This recipe calls for sesame oil. This sesame oil I picked up at Ray's Food Place. It was $7. It's kind of pricey, but it goes a long way. I'm just going to drizzle a little bit of that over top of my, about a tablespoon. I am going to grab some brown sugar. Kyle Moon and his wife Samantha made these for me. They are jars. I have my brown sugar in it. It's etched glass, as you can see the sturgeon back design on it. I'm going to grab out a little bit of brown sugar. Thank you, Lynn Abar, for my beautiful measuring cups. So many people bless me in this valley for this cooking show, so I just want to give shout outs and thank yous to them. So what I want to do with the brown sugar is I'm going to take it and I'm just going to drizzle it over top of my squash. And then I'm going to take some ground ginger. I like to buy the Ray's Food brand seasoning and herbs only because it's 100% pure. And also it's only, as you can see, $4.99 for this amount, which is a good deal. I've been reading a lot about ginger. Ginger promotes gastrointestinal support, so stuff for your stomach. If you have gassy stomach or your tummy aches a lot, this is a good support. That's why people drink ginger ale. Also, ginger is an arthritis help aid. It's an anti-inflammatory, so which brings down inflammation caused by arthritis. Ginger is a great thing to add to your diet, and it also gives some great flavor. So I'm gonna add that to my squash. Just sprinkle a little bit. A little goes a long ways with the ginger. I got some ground cinnamon. I'm gonna add that to it. So I'm just kind of promoting those fall aromas with the butternut squash. I'm gonna give it a little toss. And just evenly kind of mix up those things. And then I wanna spread it out nice and evenly on my parchment paper on my cooking sheet. I am going to add this into my oven over here, which is preheated to 400 degrees. I'm gonna wash my hands really quick. As you can see, I have a nice brand new oven. I'd like to thank Eloise Cobell for this oven because this is what I use my Cobell check with. And I just wanted to take this moment to give honor and give respect to Eloise. And I just wanted to say how thankful I am for her in Indian country, for the things and the sacrifices that she made for us as people. And I just wanted to give information on Eloise out there. Eloise Cobell was a Native American activist that took on the US government because she had seen that there was mismanagement of funds for land and IIM accounts. So she brought a class action suit in 1996 against the federal government for $3.4 billion. This was one of the largest settlements in Indian country. And I just wanted to thank you and give you honor and respect, Eloise, and just send out a message to your family that I appreciate everything that you have done for us in Indian country. Thank you so much. You know, you don't realize how great of a blessing it was to receive this Cobell money. And I'm just thankful, and I just want to honor and respect you and just give a tribute to you and your life and the cause that you have given to us as Native Americans. So thank you very much, Eloise. As you can see, it's a nice, beautiful stove. It's gonna help me cook. And I just wanted to send that out there. Eloise was a member of the Blackfoot tribe, and she was a banker and a lawyer. So, you know, I aspire to Eloise Cobell as a Native American woman. And I just really, really am thankful to have people out there that fight for our causes. All right, I think it's time to check on our squash. So I'm gonna take you over to our squash over here. Kind of zoom you in too. The oven. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do the fork test on it. And I just wanna make sure that I can press through the squash. Just like that with the fork. I'm gonna take it out of my oven. If you could just smell the aroma of that squash, it is just gorgeous. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take it off the sheet and I'm gonna put it in a bowl. I'm going to throw it into the refrigerator for a little bit while it cools. One thing I like about parchment paper is there is no stick. You don't have to put any spray or oil down, except for the olive oil that we added to the flavor of the squash. And it's so easy to clean up. I'm gonna put this in the freezer for a little bit. As you can see, my squash is nice and brown and golden. Just gorgeous. I'm gonna set this in the freezer for a little bit. I just want that to cool enough so that when I go to add it to my salad, I don't want it to wilt the kale. So the next thing that I have is I have some red Russian kale. This kale came from Grady at Greenfire Farms. We know that kale is full of rich vitamins and minerals, one of which is calcium, and it also carries iron in it, and it also carries vitamin A and vitamin C. So this salad will boost up our immune system with the kale and the squash together. So I'm gonna take it and I'm just gonna slide down it just like that, take the rib out, and I'm gonna do that with all my kale. Slide through it. As you can see, it's nice and fast to take the rib out of it when you do it that way. Now, like I said, this kale came from Greenfire Farm. I'm also going to add to it a fresh cucumber and fresh tomato, which also both came from Grady at Greenfire Farm. I'm going to add some onion. This red onion came from Hoopa Food Commodities, my food commodity this month. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring you down to my cutting board to my kale. So I have it all taken off of the stalk, and I am going to finally chop. Blender cup, my blender top, and I'm going to be using peanut butter that we received. I'm going to go up just a little bit. I'm going to be using peanut butter that we got from the food commodities. This is creamy peanut butter. I'm going to be using the olive oil from Spencer. Like I said, he has this for sale, $11 a bottle, so hit him up. I will put his name in my Facebook post when I post this online. I'm going to be using the cinnamon and the ginger in the sauce. I'm going to add some sesame seeds to the sauce as well, and some sesame oil. So I'm going to add these things in with some soy sauce and some lemon juice. I like to use fresh lemon, squeezed lemon juice, but because somebody gave this to me, I want to use it up so that it doesn't go to waste. So I'm just going to use this today. And what you want to do is you want to grab a few spoonfuls of your peanut butter and add it in just like that, and grab my rag and wipe my finger off, and then a couple little sprinkles of cinnamon, a couple sprinkles of ginger. You want to add a nice generous amount of the sesame oil, very generous amount of the lemon juice. Now I have this recipe already posted on my Facebook page, Cooking Healthy in Indian Country, and so you'll be able to see it there, and I will also post it in this video. So we got that, and we want to add a generous amount of olive oil. And we're going to add our sesame seeds. Now, because the peanut butter is already has oil in it, it will probably thicken up. So what we want to do is we want to blend it for a little bit, and then we'll check it, and then we'll add more stuff like the oil and the lemon. All right, so our squash is done. It's nice and cooled down. I'm gonna add that into my salad, but first I'm gonna thinly slice up some onions. Now this is gonna add a nice depth of flavor to our salad. So you wanna really thinly slice it. So as thin as I can get it is what I wanna do. Almost as if you can get it as paper thin as you can. That's what, how thin you would like to get these. Now I'm gonna cut these in half. And I'm gonna add them into my salad. Now we're gonna start with all kinds of nice colors. I'm gonna toss in my butternut squash. And we're gonna add some more beautiful colors to it. I'm gonna toss in some loose sesame seeds. And here we go, our roasted squash and kale salad. I'm gonna put this in my bowl. Get myself a nice little amount. I'm gonna take it. Move my stuff out of the way here. We're gonna drizzle over our sauce. It's nice and thin. I'm gonna bring you in. You can see all those beautiful colors in there. Zoom me back out. Okay, we're gonna try it out. Real good. Just that citrus flavor with that nutty sweet flavor all together, mixing together. It just bursts in your palate and gives you an amazing amount of flavor. Everything together, you know, was locally grown, or that it was locally accessible, or something that I received free. You know, this meal is gonna benefit my family very greatly, and it's just full of flavor. So, try it out. Now, I want to take this moment and thank all the people and the programs that make this possible. I'd like to thank the Klamath Trinity Resource Conservation District, the Hoopa Valley Tribe. I'd like to thank Spencer Hill at Spencer Hill Small Fruits. And I'd like to thank Grady at Greenfire Farm for all your beautiful produce. And I'd like to thank you, the viewers. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel and my Facebook page, Cookin' Healthy in Indian Country. See you again. Thank you.